Hello everyone! Today I'm going to introduce to you the Sonata in E minor, Opus 25, number 2, written by Nikolai Medtner. Before I get into the actual music itself, I want to talk a little bit more about the composer first and give some background information about him. So for starters, Nikolai Medtner was a late Romantic Russian composer, and he was also a contemporary of Sergei Rachmaninoff and Alexander Scriabin. Nikolai Medtner composed much of his pieces for piano and piano plus orchestra, including three piano concerti. And in his solo piano repertoire, a lot of his works are shorter character pieces. These shorter character pieces are known as the skazki, which translates to fairy tales in English, and he also produced the Forgotten Melodies. When we think about this Sonata in E minor, Opus 25, number 2, it is not very well known, but it is actually one of the most important works for Medtner, not only in terms of his piano literature, but also in terms of his compositional career. So for starters, the work was written in 1910 and was completed in 1911. And this was at the time in which Medtner was kind of struggling to gain recognition as a composer. Upon completion of the work, he became very famous internationally, especially in Germany, where he got lots of recognition and acclaim. The work also earned him the Glinka Prize in 1916. Now, the Glinka Prize was a very special award that was presented to Russian composers for their significant achievements in their compositional output. Now I want to talk a little bit more about the sonata itself. The Sonata in E minor, Opus 25, number 2, is also known as the Night Wind Sonata. The reason why it is called the Night Wind Sonata is because in the original score, there is an epigraph that includes a poem written by Fyodor Tyutchev, and the name of that poem is called Night Wind. I'm going to read to you the poem right now, and I want you to think about the overall characteristic and how it might possibly translate into the music. The poem goes like this. Why moan? Why wail you, wind of night, with such despair, such frenzied madness? Why is your voice now full of might, now piteous and tinged with sadness? In tongue to the known to the heart of pain, unknown to it forever chanting, at times within it, well nigh frantic, sounds you awaken and insane. Sing not, O wind, your fearful song of chaos, for the hungry spirit into night's world of shadows flung, exults in it and strains to hear it. The bounds of mortal flesh 'twould fly and merge with boundless ocean sweeping. Take heed, let slumbering tempests lie. Beneath them chaos stirs unsleeping. So in summary, the narrator is speaking to a night wind, a very troubled night wind. At first, the narrator wants to understand why the night wind is very troubled and sad. And ultimately, the narrator is simply begging for the night wind to contain his tempests and his chaos and violence. So that is the programmatic influence of the Sonata in E minor by Nikolai Medtner. Now I want to get into the actual music itself. The piece consists mainly of two motives. The first motive is characterized by a descending third, and this is to signify the threats of danger that are incoming. So the piece starts with that opening motif, and it goes like this. You can hear the descending third in that opening, and then it repeats. So that opening motif very much resembles church bells ringing or also horn calls, and both of these are very important to signify the threats of danger, as I said before. The second motif that I want to explore in this piece is the main theme, actually, that gets transformed throughout the entire piece. To put it simply, without any accompaniment, the melody itself sounds like this. It's a very vocal, arioso-like melody that can be seen as very, well, like a speaker. When we think of a poet or a narrator, we can imagine this voice as the narrator's voice speaking to the night wind. So, I will play just the first two measures, the first three measures, and you will see how these three motifs are combined together, and it really sets up the mood that matches the poem of the narrator and the very troubled night wind. So that's just a brief sample of the piece. But later on, you might notice that the piece will get increasingly more and more agitated, and that would represent the night winds out of control. He cannot contain his sleeping tempests anymore, so the piece gets more and more chaotic and very unstable. Later in the piece, you will hear that same theme come back. But this time, towards the middle, or towards the end, I should say, it's very much presented in a different setting. It's represented in a more chaotic manner. So it's much faster, but you can still hear the... So when we think about the work, it is a very narrative approach to the sonata form. It is based on the Night Wind poem by Fyodor Tyutchev, and the music very much reflects that. I hope you enjoyed this massive piece by Medtner. It is a very important work by the composer, and thank you very much.